Hey everybody, so before we get into the video today, I just wanted to let you all know that, for the past couple videos, I am sorry that I've been very, very low of me talking. So, I am sorry about that. I have fixed it. Just, obviously, for what you're seeing for right now, it does still have low quality. Like, not low quality, but, like, my voice is still really low. But, like I said, I have fixed it. So, when the next, for these next couple episodes, it will be low. You will see this for every episode, because I do feel sorry I did that. I didn't realize it, since, you know, editing Let's Plays, all I gotta do is go in at beginning, at end, and edit out what I already know I need to edit. But I didn't really notice until I played it, just one day, just played it and heard my voice, like, crap, it's too low, can't fix it now, because I'm already too far ahead in the game. But it will be fixed, don't worry about it. I got to the point where I did fix it, so for now on, once the, episode finally comes up, it will be fixed. So again, I'm sorry guys about it. Also, I'm actually not going to do any of the loyalty missions. I know I said I would, but they actually, from what I see, are like extremely like in depth and take a lot longer than what Mass Effect 2's was. So I'm probably going to skip over all of them except for like cores, because core does tie in with the Asari arc, and I'm pretty sure I need all the arcs for end game. But we're going to go through the story. Nonetheless, it's all main quests. Everything that it does in the main story of this game. So, let's get in the video. I hope you all enjoy it. And until then, I'll see you guys next time. Hello, everybody. My name is Dr. Lethal. And welcome back to Mass Effect Andromeda. Now we got to go to, what was this planet called? Ivala? I think it was called. Ooh, excuse me.
Anomaly on sensors.
Anomaly? What's right over here?
Probes launched. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
No. Okay, good. I was gonna say, why is it going there? No. But we're gonna go through the story here. Even though I do got some planets to discover in this system, but we're gonna go to this planet they want me to check out, see what's going on. I'm gonna try to find the resistance first, because I'm kind of thinking like, was anything like the original Mass Effects? Damn it. Is anything like the original Mass Effects? It does take time to do all this. Aya Trail of Hope? Huh? Oh. Okay, we're heading to Voled. Which, I don't think it's here. Is it? No, it is in fact not here, but this is a Scourge here. Look at this shit. What is, I really want to know what the Scourge is. I wonder if it's like a byproduct of Reapers. Really, it's now a whole bunch of other galaxies opened up to us. So I have to look, well, not galaxies, but clusters, I guess. I have to look through each one of these, check out the planets and stuff like that. But this is where we're heading now. I wonder if it's going to be hectic getting here. And that's so cool. Like I said again, that's really cool how when you go past the black hole, you see everything stored. Like, my understanding, that's what black holes like to do. Everything that goes around it is distorts and stretches out. That's pretty much, I think what a black hole is, it's just the absence of light, and it just absorbs light. It just pretty much makes everything around it.
Anomaly detected.
Thank you, Sabi. Pretty much make everything around it just distort it. I'm just gonna check these planets before I even land. I don't know if it's anything big to constantly like check all, get 100% on planets. That's what I used to do all the time in the other Mass Effects. This has an anomaly on it. I see it already. But I kind of like doing 100% in each little system.
Anomaly on sensors.
Yep. Boink.
Probes launched. Detecting what's left of a ship.
Oh, okay. Damn. And what I'm kind of upset with this game about is there are no Quarians.
Anomaly on sensors.
That's no problem for me, but I would like to see Quarians.
Probe away. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Like, Quarians were a cool race. It's like you got the Salarians, you got the Asarians, the Krogan, the Turians, but you don't have us, the Quarians. Like, you would think having the, well, I guess it's technically the Quarians couldn't survive, so I guess it's something they couldn't do, but you would think the Quarians would go, because they are like the best engineers in the universe. know, maybe they couldn't, again.
I'm picking up something.
They probably couldn't go simply because of, oh, right here. Probably couldn't go because of their,
deploying probe.
The hell is it,
getting a scan.
Wow, that's a pretty big storm, isn't it? It's a fucking hurricane. This planet seems livable. Covered in oceans and nitrogen, carried by powerful winds, storm make detailed surface scans difficult. I mean, it looks like a decent planet to live on. But anyway, I don't think the coins can make it because obviously they're in a suit and they can't survive outside their suit, so that's probably why they couldn't go. If they had to go to cryo, they'd probably have to get out of their suit or to be in cryo, and being in cryo might kill them. I don't know, but it would be pretty cool if the Borings did come with us. I guess I might have to search. Fuck, I don't want copper, I want platinum, dude. Give me some platinum. I gotta look up where to find platinum, because platinum is the main thing I want for my N7 gear. And that's what I want, is my N7 gear. Because I will put that in default colors, put the helmet on, and run around as Shepard. Because that's just badass. I'm glad they put that in, though. And here's the next planet. This is where we're supposed to land anyway. I'm gonna scan it.
Okay, bundle up, people.
I'll stay on my nice warm ship.
Oh, landing zone's over here. Ah, so this is another planet we can live on, so I gotta get the 5 ability level up to 100%. So I'm most likely we're gonna fight the cat, kick their ass like we normally do. And then, continue on our merry little way. What's this, something for my nomad? Oh, I love the platinum, but gold? Hell yeah. Oh, hell yeah, gold.
Take her down, Callow.
We designated this planet Habitat 6. Original readings suggest that it had a breathable, nitrogen-rich atmosphere and oceans of H2O.
I take it that's no longer the case.
All H2O on Habitat 6, Voled to the Angara, is ice. And those oceans, frozen over completely.
There goes the dream of a seaside property.
That's cool.
It's a pretty intense blizzard.
LZ is on the windward side of the mountain. Conditions are bad. I'm tracking gale force squalls.
Us to get out and push?
Very funny, Ryder.
Wait, why is PB and Drax? Hold up. No. Come on, I'll be right back. I gotta switch characters. I don't know why these two came out with it. I guess I screwed up. I'll be right back. Alright. Now that I've actually got the people that I want to help with news, it's all in veteran. Continue on. Cold hazard.
Whew, Subi wasn't kidding about the cold.
Negative 52 degrees Celsius. Taking a lot of my hazard.
Good place for a secret hideout. The snow and ice camouflages everything.
Keep going, Ryder. Try not to make any sudden movements. You're probably being watched.
Great. They really mean business, don't they?
That's cool. You better have a place to carry or else I'm fucked. Yeah. Oh shit, this
needs ammo. Oh my god, look at that thing. 18 shots. Should be fine, though. I remember using that gun all the time in Mass Effect 3. My favorite gun is the Vulture.
Peter, right ahead. I need a minute to defrost.
We're almost there. We'll need to talk to Commander Anyek when we arrive.
Jesus.
Life support restored. Extreme cold is detected, Pathfinder.
No shit.
I'm reading a normal temperature range, Pathfinder. Life support restored.
So it just seems like it's cold. That's it. It doesn't any harmful to us or anything.
Oh, I love you, Hera.
Hey there, Laura.
Who knows how much time we have?
Trust me, this'll work.
Ah, okay, yeah, so they are speaking a different language.
First time you switch it on. The whole thing is going to blow.
Don't be so dramatic. I do this all the time.
Marshall's dead. You saw the explosion. Wow. Container. Gorilla armor. Interesting. Ooh, and my incendiary ammo. It's nice. I can always use that.
Got a message from my little brother this morning. He asked when I'm coming home.
He's young. He doesn't understand yet.
I don't know how to respond. How do you tell a child you might not come back?
That's something hard to do, too.
Good to see you again, Commander Dalziel.
And you, Jarl. This is the alien. The one you think can help us.
Yes. This is Ryder, of the Andromeda Initiative.
I am Anyek Dalziel. Remember the name. Because if you betray us, I will kill you myself. Be assured that what I do to you will make the stars turn their faces and grow dark.
I have no intention of betraying you.
Say what you want. It is the hands that reveal true intention. If you wish to prove yourself, be an ally in our fight against the Kett. Despite our best efforts, their growing forces remain a threat to our people. Speak to our lookouts who watch the valley. They'll know where our need is dire. Jarl, watch them, and be careful yourself, my friend.
I always am.
Okay, speak to the resistance and look out. Alright, that's kind of surveillance footage. Can I scan one? Yeah, you see the Nomad in action. Here, yeah, it's right here.
Looks like supplies aren't getting through to the Resistance.
Olisk is in charge of requisitions. We should speak with him.
Pathfinder, something I can do for you? You the requisitions officer? I hear you're having supply issues.
Of course not. I don't know what you've heard, but everything is running fine.
I saw.
Your communications say otherwise. You haven't received a shipment in weeks.
Those data pads are encrypted. How did you? I need to keep this news contained. No one knows the shipments have stopped. If word gets around, we'll have a serious morale drop. I need to investigate this quietly.
You have any leads?
Not much. The supplies make it planetside, but never reach the base. The obvious answer is the Kett. Sabotage is their style. We changed our drop point, but no luck. I can't send someone to investigate without word getting around. I guess there's no avoiding it eventually.
I'll check it out for you.
I can take a look at the drop point. That way no one will panic.
I can't sanction an official search, but I also can't stop you from investigating on your own. The nav point for the last drop location is in my personal console. You seem to be adept at decryption, so I'll let you figure out the rest.
All right, well, I'll do that later. We're gonna go over here and,
Joe, my friend. Welcome home, brother.
He's like, well, yeah, cool, whatever. Let's go check out, see what, speak to these lookouts. Wow. It could be that they just... No, they couldn't have sank something to resist it.
Temperatures are below freezing and continuing to fall.
Yep, they're staring.
But I brought the snacks last.
Let's try to make a good first impression.
But I never get care packages from our
good to be back.
Do I?
I have
You're
friends
so
here.
You're so good at guilting me.
Life support restored.
Whoa! Didn't mean to sneak up on you. Your commander said you could show us the valley.
Zeke, I don't want to talk to it. You talk to it.
Ryder has a name.
You named it? How'd you even tell them apart?
Stars, Beniska, just stop talking.
Yeah, we can show you the valley. What are you looking for?
To help Angara.
I'm here to help your people. Know anyone who needs it?
We've got reports from Hajara about someone trying to rescue a kidnapped family. See those red lights? That's it. If you're here to help, like the commander says, you could start there. Anything else?
Red lights.
Those red lights. You said that's Hajara?
Yes. Hajara Station. One of the Dar in the valley. It's a small community, mostly scientists. There's people there that might need help if you haven't checked it out already.
Is it difficult to live out here?
Why so surprised? We've adapted to this weather.
Those lights are conspicuous. Don't the Kett attack?
We've adapted to that too. The Kett want to take us alive, so we fight to the death. It seems to deter them.
What's that alien facility on that mountain over there?
That's the Kett Command Center. We have constant eyes on it.
What's its purpose?
It controls Kett operations on the entire planet. There's always ships coming and going.
I came face to face with the prefect there. Meanest, motherless Bissan I ever saw.
Even the Kett seemed afraid. We don't have much intel on her, though.
Do you know of any remnant sites or ruins?
I think so. Actually, I don't know.
Zeke, do you ever read the dailies?
No. You'll tell me if I need to know something.
So where is it?
Tall lights. Over on your right somewhere.
Thanks.
I'll let you get back to your work.
Yeah, you behave. We're watching you.
That helps me out.
Tempest, we're gonna need the Nomad. My position.
Deploying forward station. Good luck, Ryder.
Activating automated forward station deployment. Mining zones in this region are available, Pathfinder. I've added them to your nav system.
Activate Nomad. We need it.
Okay, Sam, what's Voled got for us?
Kett activity appears to be centered around this large central command post. According to Resistance Intelligence, the base coordinates all Kett military efforts on Voled.
And taking it down will cripple their operations.
In theory. However, given the trouble the Angara Resistance has had infiltrating the base, it will not be a simple task. I recommend a more cautious approach that starts with the investigation of smaller Kett installations.
Any suggestions on how to get on Ephra's good side?
Resistance dispatches indicate there is someone in Hajara who needs help. We could visit Tekix, a larger and more established Angara Dar that is nearby.
Sounds good. Thanks, Sam.
Pathfinder, Voled's temperature range is fixed well below freezing, with pockets of even more severe conditions. This necessitates the use of the Nomad. I advise against prolonged exposure to the cold.
Just like being off.
Got it. Don't crash the car.
Our scans have detected remnant monoliths, which suggests the presence of a vault.
And that means we might be able to melt this ice cube. All right, we've got our work cut out for us. Let's get going.
Being on Novaria again.
Follow the lights, Ryder.
Trust me.
Can you even see through this snow?
Yes. Holy shit!
Okay. out of the worst of it. Temperature should be manageable now.
Pathfinder, this area can be mined for resources. You can extract minerals via your mining interface.
I wonder if we'll ever see a so-called golden world that won't be complete death to live on.
Did your people have plans to settle here? You seem easily affected by the cold. What you said is true, Fedra. In my lifetime, I've known only war, occupation, extermination.
We're going to change that, Jal.
All right, well, yeah, we're
automated forward station deployment.
Angara is a research station, mostly focusing on Voled's geology.
Let's see if someone here needs help.
Environment check.
We can't just
temperatures
attack
are within acceptable
space.
Parameters.
So you're just giving up on Neelch? He was your best friend.
No. I'm saying we need to think about this. Get in touch with Buxton and form a proper plan.
They could be dead or worse by the time your thinking's done.
Yeah.
You're that alien people have been talking about. Some say we can't trust you. But if you're here to fight Kett, that's good enough for me.
Thanks.
I appreciate the vote of confidence.
Kett killed people. They take our families and we never see them again. Anyone who fights against that has to be better than them. So, will you fight them? I know the location of the labor camp where they took my uncle.
What's a Kett labor camp for?
Different things. They put people in cages there. Sometimes they make them work. Sometimes they collect Angara, and once they have enough, they move them. And sometimes they just kill them. My father died that way.
I'm so sorry.
Don't be sorry. Make sure I don't lose more family.
I'll get your uncle.
Here's the nav point of the labor camp. Please hurry. Nilge may not have much time.
Alright, so we're gonna do that. We're gonna try to help him out. Gotta do as much as we can to help people.
I'm reading a temperature decrease.
Now I'm thinking about that one job I did, drilling for Ezo on an ice planet.
Someone around here probably knows what that ice is for.
I hear the researchers here drill into the ice in order to study it.
The ambient temperature is normal. Life support at 100%.
Someone said this Aurelia arrived at the resistance base. Now here you are. Oh, wish I could talk. But I gotta get this sky-cursed piece of junk working. It's been picking up weird interference for days. I can't transmit data to our colleagues in Talara.
Is there something I can do?
Maybe. I didn't think you'd be familiar with our machines. Oh, I need to take a break before I kill someone. If you want, feel free to poke around.
Easy. Wow. He's up a good amount of that. I got 85 research data left because of my, thing.
High-powered communications array. Most likely for planet-wide communications.
Makes sense. Anything on that interference the researcher talked about?
I am detecting a signal. It is faint, but this equipment is sensitive. Pathfinder, I also observe a regular pattern in this emitted signal. Can be mined for resources. You can extract minerals via your mining interface.
That's Kett tech. Stay alert. Revenant pillars ahead. Might give us trouble. Labor camp Skion talked about.
Be careful. Looks heavily guarded.
Oh.
overdrive pack, whatever the fuck that means. So I kind of do like, just like with, what they do it with, I'm thinking of it as, Battlefield, you see like everything.
You're here to rescue us. The control panel is right there. Shut this down.
Yeah, I'm here to rescue you. At least with Battlefield, you see all the,
Once I have a weapon, I'm gonna destroy these Kett! I have to get out! Freedom!
I'm reading a temperature decrease.
Hey, wait, I gotta talk to you. Don't run from her. What the fuck? What the hell?
Environmental temperatures are within acceptable limits.
Just in time. Would have given us another day at most. No thanks for Rana's jabs.
If the Kett can't handle being called mildly insulting things, that's on them, not me.
You see what I mean? We owe you. How'd you find us anyway?
Your nephew Skiat was trying to get you rescued.
Good boy. He's got potential, Nilt.
So you've said before. The Resistance needs to be debriefed. We'll head back to base as soon as possible.
What about the data drive? We have to deliver it to Buxel so she can start the analysis.
Interesting. It seems we have to depend on our rescuer for more than a rescue. Can you deliver this drive to Tejix? If we work together, no time will be wasted.
Right away. I'm not gonna question it.
I'll go there as soon as I can.
Perfect. Buxel will be in her workshop. I hope we meet again, under better circumstances.
This is big. Liberating key Resistance agents and recovering information they stole from the Kett. You've put many doubts about you to rest, Ryder. Even Ephra must now be convinced of your intentions.
What about the data drive Neil's entrusted to us?
Good point. If you prefer, you could go to Tejix now and speak to Ephra later. The choice is yours.
I need to get this data drive to Tejix. I can deal with Ephra later.
I thought you might say that. Very well. We'll talk to Ephra when you're done with your tasks here.
Life support is back online.
Alright guys, but this is going to bring us to the end of this episode. Thank you all so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like button for me. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And when you do, hit the little bell icon, because I do upload on a daily basis. And you will get notified as soon as I upload. So once again, thank you all so much for watching. And as always, I will see you in the next episode. Sayonara for now, everybody. Yeah.